Right, this all happened a little while ago. I didn't get here in time to watch the unloading off the beet harvester, but Major was finished a bit early, so we got a bit early. There's a stew, and he's just about to go to bugger off and go back home. So we just wave goodbye to him and thank you very much for the prompt delivery. He's a very careful driver. Yeah, just see him go over the bridge. So what we will be doing today is Kylie unloaded the beet house because it's her chance to drive. She doesn't get many chances to drive that. She'd be driving that. I'll be driving that actually, and she'll be dumping the stuff. I just got to sort of where we're going to dump it. And with that, it's goodbye to Stu. Well, as you noticed earlier, we got the dropped off. I'm now about to unfold it and get it all ready to go. We will start the beet harvest. Almost the final harvest of the year. Just check we've got everything done on here. We'll leave the pipe until we need it. Right, let's get back inside. Switch on and let's get rolling. You can see I am driving the beet harvester as much as Kylie wants to. At least she's got the job of unloading it. She's in the JCB, acting as the unloading. Doing the unloading, acting as. I'm hoping I can get a lap done before she has to start to unload me, but that isn't a given. We want a good crop here. We badly need one. You see, we're just about 80,000 plus the loan in the red. We've still got to pay Bale and Davis for the transport. We paid them for delivering the barley, but we just got to pay for dropping off this piece of a rather excellent kit. Not too much has been happening, but I didn't do too much last night, although I have got a council meeting coming up. And well, a committee meeting again, so we're to see how that goes. At least now with the 5 people on the committee, it's not going to be all one-way traffic. I will have somebody on my side. Not going too bad so far. And what we're doing with the beet is we're just making a heap out near the dirt track, and hopefully Stu, when we're ready to deliver, and that's been delivered down at the rail's head, he can come along with the Phoenix and pick that up. I will move one of the conveyors over there. I've got the one on 11, isn't too far away, and I'm actually seriously thinking about selling one of the conveyors. We don't need Boo, we just move the one about where we need it at the time. Just have to wash it down probably between times. Might mean buying a second washer somewhere. And I had a look at the BGA and that half bunker, it well, should be ready later on today. Maybe this afternoon. And hopefully Phil will be able to come and do the job for us. Cash in hand, of course. He just doesn't trust me, you know. He thinks we're going belly up at any time. And for those who are really worried, I have enough money in my own personal account, which I put aside from the good years, to cover most of the debt. Yes, I'm not too bad off. If you are sensible and put money to one side on good years, just for these bad times. Nothing too much can go wrong in the long run, long as we don't get too many bad years. I was gonna do two, I think, and I'm gonna get GPS running, and we're gonna. Now I might just check what we're like on this far, and I think we can probably get away with three headlands. And how we're doing there, we're still waiting. Yeah, the first thing, once I think this holds enough, so it will be unload the harvester, then just run around and unload the trailer and get ready back to unload me again, because I don't think there'll be much space in the trailer by the time this has been unloaded, and I will need to straighten some of these edges up. I will probably have to go back and forth a few times to do that. Of course, this end we are going to want a lot more space. We're not going to turn around here very well. I haven't checked on the top fields today. I will have to go and see if they want any attention. I'm going to plant straight inwards alfalfa now. I'm not going to bother to plow this. We will plow the alfalfa at the end of it, but I think I can get away with just shoving the alfalfa straight in and give it a good plow and the excuse expression. During the late winter, early spring, I will probably just straight alfalfa into 11. That's where the organic stuff is going. Five and six, I will probably give those a full work. I can't remember, I already have. I may well have done. My memory isn't what it should be. And we're getting there, and she's now on her way, so I'll just put the pipe out. Hopefully she won't get caught on anything. There she comes, you can tell the lights are on. I don't know how many times I tell her not to bother with the lights, but she always does. And she's offloading me now. The deer's getting. This is probably the worst place possible for her to get away from. Remember, Kylie's the one who normally takes out bus stops. Ooh. Yeah, I'm gonna have to straighten some of this out a bit. Now she's gone, and I should imagine she's got a full load, and I should imagine she's now about to hit something. Can't see which way she's facing, but she's still moving at the moment, which is a miracle. So saying, just see what she's up to. Yeah, I was afraid she's going to do that. That's it, she's gonna find a way now. all the way around. There we are. Be better once we get into the field more. This is quite a big field. As it's mostly our fields, an interesting shape. It's even worse before we split 12 into 3. And because the third part we just don't use, it's just not worthwhile. There's no easy way to it. And I think we want to start straightening some of this up. I think what we're going to do is we're going to go across the top here, try and level it off there, and aim straight for the other peak. Miss that bit out there completely. Now she's made the tip. Come at the edge of this, I think. Just try and square the field up a bit. That isn't too bad then, this edge. In fact, looking at it, this might be the best edge to try once we're ready to go for up and down. This is a straight edge. Right, as we are now getting fairly well through the year, our winter work is in hand. Once we get through all the cutting, I think we're going straight here actually. We will get on with the winter work, which is going to be quite a bit. There will be a few changes around the farm. And hopefully we will tidy up a bit. None of us are looking forward to clearing that pond out. We don't really know what we're going to find when we dive in there with our nets and grapples and what have you. I reckon we'll find a lot of supermarket trolleys. If they're in good condition, I shall rebrand them and send them over to Darren. And he's certainly thinking about increasing the size of the shop. I want to go straight down here. I'm not going to cut much down here, but we're going to go straight down to try and ease some of this bulge, isn't it? We just take this bit off here. I think actually we need to. Oh, it's on total steer. I'm not certain if we had already on total steer or not. I'm keeping the spare out now. We shouldn't go close enough to the trees to collect it. Famous last words. I'm afraid I split this into two. We'll do. You have two visits to see the beet being cut and harvested. As you know, Paul's off today. We do allow him some time off. Right, I'm going to do the sounds I've done before. I'm missing that bit out there. I'm going to come across here again. Just slowly ease it down to a better shape. I certainly need to take another couple of passes out here. Compaction will be terrible here, but I'm hoping I can get away with just direct drilling alfalfa in here. That won't mind too much with a little bit heavy for it. Straighten this edge right up, hopefully, this time. Alright, we're going to get over 100 ton out of here by the looks of it. Now, as a fact, we will, before it's up to standard, get extra for our crop. I don't think I can complain, although I will. You know, us farmers, we're always complaining. The rain is too wet, the sun is too shiny. We will find a reason to complain about everything. I really must drop the class in to Jordan to get him just to check that over, especially the header. It's beginning to make a few funny noises towards the end, so we need that looked at. The header like that, with as complex as that one is, I'm not even going to attempt to do that myself. I think we'll give it, well, I think we'll go fully into it now and get one lap and we'll start going up and down. So this is the side, if you fill up here, that Kylie has troubles with. Well, she has troubles with everywhere. That's a famous bus shelter she always gets. I'm not going to follow the contour here, I'm going to go straight across here and not cut anything. I'm trying to think what other work got and what we're putting where. With straw, we will certainly need some more, because what we don't use before next harvest, I will sell. I don't like having old straw, and also far too valuable to give them old straw. It's like giving someone old spice as a deodorant. Have to do another one at the top here, because I don't think I'm going to turn it around this end. Must be almost to the point where she's going to start chasing me. Been looking at the catalogues and they're looking at Homer. An extra row. But there's no way I could afford what it. If I was to keep doing Beet and we didn't have this, I'd be down to using the two-pass system. Although you can put the header on or the cutter on the front and the lifter on the back. Big problem is the cutter is a lot wider than the lifter, so you're actually better off, I find, doing two passes. I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to make it easy for me. I'm going to stop here and let her offload me here. She might get away alright. I'm hoping she will fill up this time. Fill up again. Oh yeah, she's gonna have enough. Alright, we'll carry on again. She probably won't go where I am. This, I hope she soon turns off. Those lights are blinding. So it'd be all really good back and forth on these turns now. Getting rather a mess on the corners. She's reached the heap. I'm just gonna get my flask out. Always have plenty to drink on the land. There's a lot of dust about. Even in all this modern air-conditioned stuff. Hell, I missed a couple of beet there, that won't do. Right, what I'm going to do, I think, is turn it off for a moment. Back up and take this out again. And we can also pick up those two beet we missed. Mean meat, never. I think we might have enough room now with this steering on as we got it. So I think we'll get down to the bottom. Do I use GPS or not? No, I don't think I will. I think I'll risk... the fields are such that a lot of GPS is nice. You need to square them off properly before you start. You can see our heap over in the distance. It's growing. Oh, it's a lot still to go. We're going to get. I think 200 ton is not going to be out the way. Looking at that. We'll run onto the other field, it's empty. Can't do it at the other end, but we can do it at this end. It's probably more efficient to go round and round, but it does mean you're going tighter and tighter turns all the time. Once we've got no straight edge like this, we might as well make use of it before it disappears. Turn this end is going to be fun, especially with the trees in the way. What I may do is actually go to the side and take some more off the top here. Some off the top, sir. See this end. There we go. I'm not going to go right into it because I want to try and straighten this off a bit. What I want to do is something very silly. I'm going to go straight through here. Then do this little bit at the top there separately. And hopefully we will have straightened this lot up nicely. That watch out for how much we've got in there now, because I don't want her driving over it, so if I can help it. She will be, but I'll just make it a little bit easier by squaring this end off. All I want to do is carry on and come down this side now, so I'll just lift that. We do more of that next time we can't pair. You can see how we are mangling the field. I could put it in the crab mode, which would ease the compaction a bit, but we're not going to be growing a crop as such in here. But all the alfalfa may get taken and put into the BGA. Rather than used as fertilizer. Still means we will have to fertilize, but well, she's going to drive all the crop this time, because we ain't got any choice. We've got to come down this side. Unless we make the end before we get 20,000 litres in. It's only half full, so this thing will hold 40,000 litres. I could put a stop on her until of the weight, but she may hold anyway until I turn. There she is, she's holding. So what I'm going to do actually is go and get another bit of this up here. If she should decide to come there, it isn't going to matter. I have to come round on the, you go on to the outside of this, as he's staying away from me at the moment. It's not the most efficient way. Efficient farming is not my idea. I know BP's gone in for efficiency, but I'd like to have a little bit of a laugh whilst I'm doing it. Oh, here she come. Oh, what am I... Hopefully I can get through her and she won't get caught on anything. And she can often load me when I get to the end of this. Be another load. Come down the other side, come back up again, and then finish this bit off up here. Turn that off for a moment. some weeds are growing in there, but they're not too bad, huh? Surprise, there she goes. You can see when you look in the back of the trailer just how heavy Beet are. That amount of grain aboard and it would be almost overflowing on that old Marshall trailer. Being Beet, it's only just in the, it's only about 3/4 of the way up. We could actually do, as farmers quite often doing that on the field, and that's overfill the thing, fill it until it starts coming out to the side. But nah, I can't be bothered. Get to be my theme, that can't be bothered. Yes, I think we'll get another trial load and we'll stop for now, and you can come back, we'll finish it off next time. And I think that'll be tomorrow. We'll have both of the members of Bales and Davis here, Stu to empty the, transport the Beet over to the railhead, and Phil will be emptying the BGA. And then I will settle up with them. Now I know that Phil doesn't even trust me to pay him a check, so I'm going to have to go into the bank before tomorrow and pull out some money to pay him with cash. It's terrible, you know, when you're just not trusted. Pass up there, we might as well finish this off now as we're here. Look, let's see if I can see BP and his infamous camera about. He's probably here somewhere. He always is when we're doing something like this. Mainly to see if we make a mistake. Just gonna come out and just see. Yeah, that's all clear. Now it's just straight up and down the side, and this side will get easier further along we get to the field. Turned in too sharp. We might have just got the top caught on that branch. I'm not going to take any more of the trees, butcher any more of the trees. Well, I will do as they keep growing, but I'm not going to actually freshly butcher one now. I'll try and come straight down this row where I've got a bit off square again. Charlie's probably twiddling her fingers at the moment, wanting me to get on and keep her busy, but she's going to be busier enough in the next few weeks. Alright, follow this edge, we should be okay. Funny, I keep following the edge, but it keeps going off course. That's not me, you know, not my driving. Anyway, we're a bit off here. Going very slowly, we should just about catch this rail. I don't like leaving Beet in the ground. Makes the place look untidy, and it's money that I'm not going to get from, or rather the farm company isn't going to get from. I'm going to stop calling it my farm now. Attempt to turn around here. We might just have done it. I'm not going to look to see if I went into the hedge or not. You have to sort that out for yourselves. As far as I'm concerned, I didn't. Yeah, should finish this off next time nicely, I think. Yeah, we're getting well through this now. I remember we've got three or four passes the other side, and the rolls are getting slightly shorter as we're going in. We've got to watch out where she's parked. Actually, want to get around there. I may have to go across the top here, taking a couple more passes out. No, it should be all right. We can just about turn in there. Mother-in-law's got this new version of that game she keeps playing, Farming Simulator, umpteen and one or whatever it's called. She seems rather impressed. Has kept her quiet for a while anyway. Next thing we know, we're here quietly talking to herself as she's attempting to change something in the game. I can't understand myself. He wouldn't catch me playing games like that, but there. It's her money she's spending on it. Just about. Yeah, we just about missed the hedge. Only just. And we should fill up again going down this time, and I will wait again. I'll get to the end of the row and wait for her to come and empty me, I think. Now as she comes, we thought we'd use the JCB. It's the best of our tractors by a long way, and it might as well start getting dirty before it has to start doing some field work. Reminds me, I must go and wash this when I've finished. Marara and swing around the end with white hair. And I will just do that. And I'm going to say thank you very much for watching. If you liked what you saw, please consider leaving a like. It helps me, helps the channel, makes me feel appreciated. And I'm going to just follow her on foot. If you're not a subscriber and wish to subscribe, please do so. We are always happy to have extra people aboard. Any comments, queries, questions you've got, feel free to post them in the comments section below this video. I will try my best to answer. Oh yeah, how much we got in there anyway? Well, it's coming up to 100,000. Yeah, it's 80,000 and see how far we got. Let's go into sprint mode. Oh, but you didn't think I could run that fast. Yeah, I think don't think we're quite done half, so we shouldn't be far short. Alright, with that I'm going to say, it's me, I'm saying cheerio for now. Cheerio.